this was just a stupid novelty song to me before I did this episode. And now it is a song from one of my favorite artists I've ever covered here. I feel nothing but happiness listening to this. And though he is no longer with us, I truly believe that the Scatman is still out there in Scatland, making our dreams come true.
This was the home of Mehran Karimi Nasseri, better known as Sir Alfred. In his home, he did normal home things like eat, sleep, wash up, relax. Really, the only thing that made his home unique was that it was Terminal 1 of Paris Charles de Gaulle Airport.
...26,461 attempts later, Abney had accomplished what was thought to be impossible. Chocolate Mountain had been all but destroyed. All the years of figuring out shortcut after shortcut, taking world record after world record, had finally culminated in a 3 out of 3 weather tanko.
I gotta get out of here.
Well, hopefully it's bigger than yours.
Oh, it is. Bigger than... both of ours are bigger than yours.
What the frick am I supposed to do?
You're coming with me. No, he's coming with me and Mark, okay?
No, I'm not going with you, Dad. You like penis.
There's nothing wrong with liking a little penis.
So you said it was a big penis.
It is a big penis. Mark's got the biggest penis in the world. Besides mine.
And if you ain't man enough to respond to this video and accept our challenge, then you're a little bitch, you're a little bitch, and a little bitch. I'll fucking kill you. I'll kick your butt. I'll touch your butt in a non-consensual way. I'll beat you up, kid, bitch.
Life as Tumblr tries to pretend this is worse.
You're kind and sensitive when you don't even have to be. Grow up. God, you're not the only one in Arcadia Bay with problems. Kate Marsh almost... yes, Kate Marsh almost killed herself. Such sad, okay? That doesn't make me feel any better about my fucked up life. Get it?
You are a cunt. You are a cunt.
Niggers.
In the early hours of September the 26th, 1983, the command center just outside Moscow was awoken by the sound of an alarm. An intercontinental ballistic missile had just been launched by the US and was now heading towards the Soviet Union. In the event of a nuclear attack by the Americans, it was standard procedure to launch an immediate counterattack. It was now up to the man in charge, Stanislav Petrov, to contact his superiors and to inform them that a nuclear attack was imminent.
That song, and that was a moment in time. I've never seen anything like that happen.
Yeah.
I remember Kanye called me and he said, I know this is good. I know niggas is gonna say this is the best verse of my album. I'm taking a chance by putting this shit on here, man. You know what I'm saying? He took other takes and put them together in one take. Pink wig, thick ass, give them whiplash. Because I did not want all those grunting sounds. These niggas are one track minded. He was like, nah, I like that. That's dope. I was like, no.
There's this unusual shot of a boy riding a tricycle down a long hall before being confronted by two strange-looking little girls. And something about the scene just felt off. Like, really, really off. I sat there transfixed, feeling afraid but having no idea why. I couldn't get that scene out of my head, and I was trying and failing to not get too creeped out. Until later that night, when I had to admit defeat, hang my head in shame, and call for my parents to pick me up. The ultimate social disgrace for a 10-year-old at a birthday party.
Its cinematic influence bled into video games, where its virtual representation reflects the real steel weapon, and the lust for power of those who wield it. Unrestrained exhibition. Terrifying potency. and who cares about practicality? When you've got a golden gun that shoots giant bullets.
Welcome to Sonic Team. We make games, I think.
Aye, right.
What the fuck is a Sonic?
YouTube never changes. Since the dawn of humankind, when our ancestors first started complaining about Mass Effect 3's ending, to that time we spelled Gesamt Kunstwerk wrong, to that time we started talking about Michael Jordan for some reason, our species has sought the answer to one simple question. What the hell does shandification mean?
Hi, my name is Tony, and this is Every Frame of Painting. Today I'm going to talk about one of the greats of the last 20 years, the Japanese filmmaker Satoshi Kon. Even if you don't know his work, you have certainly seen some of his images. He is an acknowledged influence on both Darren Aronofsky and Christopher Nolan, and he has a fan base that includes just about everyone who loves animation.
The Star Wars prequels are bad movies. Nobody is debating that they are bad movies. Does it suck to watch the Star Wars prequels? Frequently, yes. Is every scene of dialogue in the Star Wars prequels the most bizarre, kludgy, embarrassing, like, pop culture stew, and simultaneously the most turgid Freudian nightmare mess of psychology that has ever ended up in one of these massive blockbuster films? Yes.
I killed them. They're dead. And the children, too. And I slaughtered them like animals.
To be angry is to be human.
And then, even though Anakin's strikes far outweigh his successes, she still marries the guy after knowing him for only like 3 days. You know what? I take it all back. I take back every piece of criticism I ever said about the guy. George Lucas, I present you with the Totally and Completely Understands Women trophy.
When creating a character, it's important to take into account which server you plan to play on, as well as the current state of the meta on that server. Most builds don't have the mobility required to change servers, so you want to make sure you know what you're getting into. But which server is the best choice for you, and which abilities can give you a leg up on the competition there? This is the first of a new series which will examine all of those things and more. Today we're taking a look at one of the more notorious servers, Australia.
I don't remember why I first saw the mountains, but they've always been here. Now that I see them, I'm wondering why they're there. But they're here. I can't climb them. But I can, cause that's the- Hey, here's the mail. Dear Steve, that's not my name, but whatever. Dear Steve, how did you climb this mountain? Well, I'm glad you asked that. It's part of a two-step program. Find the mountain, climb the thing.
That's the way we can get things done, and that's how I do it. It's easy and simple, cause you know what to do.
Work ethic!
Disgusting!
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 Hand me a baseball bat and give me the legal ability to break the right leg of every man in America, and I'll close the wage gap tomorrow!
It's clobbering time!
Competition! What is this? The free market? What's the point of trying to be good at something if it's only gonna make you better and successful?
Marx debunked success!
Alright, if you take this pill, you wake up in your bed and the Sherlock TV series was never made. It was all a bad dream. If you take this pill, you have to watch all of it again.
Oh, cool. What do you want in return? Do I need to, like, suck your dick or something?
What? No, I'm going to shoot you if you don't take either pill, but you've got to take one. That's all.
Really? Wow, you just talked yourself out of a sweet deal, mister.
Oh.
Sign me the fuck up, sailor.
I forgot where I was going with this bit. I'm sorry.
I don't know about you, but nothing brings my apathetic crank to full fucking attention like nasal phlegm and 100 degree fevers. I mean, if Michael had been so inclined, and he wasn't, folks, he basically had a ready-made pedo chateau at Neverland, and the Chandlers want us all to believe he decided to bone the kid on foreign soil in the completely uncontrollable environs of the World Music Awards in Monaco while they were both miserably ill, and not one fucking day after Michael Jackson was photographed with the accuser and his sister bouncing on his butt fucking lap.
Operant conditioning is so effective, it's actually been used to train pigeons how to recognize signs, play ping pong,
and distinguish Impressionist paintings from Cubist paintings, I kid you not. We can see this learning process when people use special moves in a fighting game. For example, Nash's EX Moonsault. If the move hits your opponent, we're likely to use it again. If the move gets punished or is not very effective, you'll be less likely to use it. This simple fact of conditioning is why people spam moves. If it works and you don't know how to stop it, expect to see the move again and again.
You know, everybody pretty much acknowledges he's the man. And I still feel that underrates him.
So what is it about Kubrick films that escalate them to the highest tier of cinema? Well, you'll find that every project is received as an artistic revolution, not just in the context of his other work, but in the domain of film itself. His filmmaking techniques are striking, but these salient approaches define the man as a director of extremes, both in content and execution.
This is the very pinnacle of enlightenment. I'm talking full-on blast up your ass. So fast, lesbo phantasm, girl-on-girl-gasm, pucker-up, D-cup, vagina bump. Doki-doki, spit-swap, roller coaster, your cock can't even handle, son. Sell your soul to the Yuri gods, motherfucker, no turning back. Anime of all time.
And I just think that you guys should try and be a little more sensitive about it.
And my favorite game of the year goes to... Super Mario Brothers 2 again, baby!
Super Mario Brothers 2!
Oh, still the king!
Still the king
after all these years!
While everyone is still sitting in that room waiting for the show to start, they changed the rules on the website so that there are no refunds. But don't worry, there's a silver lining. Everyone who paid extra to see Welcome to Night Vale is entitled to a free extra hour in the ball pit.
This is what your $17,000 went to.
And with that, a meme is born.
I don't think they're ready for this one. Jump in the pit.
I refused to bet. I just waited for the perfect hand and waited. And oh God, here come the blinds again. I realized that I was just paying money to sit there. I was gonna lose it all if I just kept going like this. So I gotta make a move. Oh shit, I have pocket aces. Is there a speed between zero and light speed? I don't know. Who could say? I'm all in. Holy shit, I won. I just made $200 by playing cards. Okay, now I'm on a roll. I have a straight. Nobody ever has a straight. That's like one in a billion. This is amazing. I just won this money.
I'm over $300.
I'm gonna bet on cards. Three, good, right? Which way am I going? I don't know. Who cares? What does anything mean? I don't know. Wait, what just happened? I don't know. What? Oh my God. Oh my God, it's all gone. I had just gone from $100 to $300 to nothing in 7 minutes.
Just don't get too carried away.
I am not getting carried away.
Hey, Vsauce. Michael here. Skeletons are scary and spooky. But you know what else is? Teenagers. Their attitude, the way they dress, and the music they listen to. Can you even call it music? Kids these days. But what are kids these days?
Now, if I were doing mock awards this year, number two in my bottom five would win the Farting the Moonlight Sonata Award for Desecration of Classics. I mean none other than the execrable Metroid Other M. Team Ninja gave Samus Aran a voice just so she could simper at all the boys. Making Metroid heavily story-based was the first mistake, and mistakes 2 through 75 all involved turning one of gaming's toughest female icons into a shrieking mimsy in a submissive relationship with a bellend in a fancy cap.
Yeah, America.
It's better campsite than your mom made.
Right.
With your vagina.
Yeah. That's good.
There's a lot of room.
It's
in
like
there,
you really thought of that.
It was like spacious.
So she made her own campsite inner vagina.
We all helped pitch the tents, and then we all camped out inside there.
Okay, that's pretty good.
Like, she had to take the patch off to prevent it from limiting her, right? Oh no, that was just metaphor or something, because the real world patch just explodes. I'm not kidding, this happens, it just explodes on her neck. Her belief in her own power overpowered the 6-year-long power limiter, meaning that this is a power limiter that only limits the subject's power if they believe their power is limited. Who wrote this?
Even after hundreds and thousands of articles and studies about how McDonald's is bad for you and about how poorly their business is run and about how much it sucks to work there, and after decades of being the punchline and jokes about having a shitty job and being dirt-ass poor, after one of the most infamous documentary smear campaigns of the 2000s, tons of people around the world still eat McDonald's because it's convenient. Because it's familiar. Because it's there.
Even worse than any of this is the Shrine of Winter, which makes sense physically, but not logically. The player is expected to kill the 4 old ones or amass a million souls before this will open, and all it does is circumvent a pile of rubble. A small pile of rubble blocks the way in the forest, so rather than climb over it, the character kills 4 of the most powerful beings in existence. I understand why they want the Drangle Castle gated off until later, but this ridiculously poor level design shattered my suspension of disbelief so hard it never recovered. It might have died in Alia's Keep anyway, where a bunch of creatures sit around in cages they're easily capable of demolishing.
But the fact is, I know most of the people watching this still don't get it, and still aren't listening. And I'm sure a good number of you just can't wait to voice your displeasure in the comments section. Fuck this. What is this? What am I doing this for? This karaoke machine was $100. That's what I spend my... These cameras? This set, getting everything ready. I wrote this fucking video a year ago. And for what?
Stone Cold Steve Austin is a man who cannot be controlled. Because the second you try, he'll blow up your bus, fill your car with cement, and spray you with beer from a fire hose. And most importantly, he'll give the people what they want.